First up tonight, a tricky subject that concerns many young Australian families, childcare. We know it's costly, we know it's complicated, and often understaffed, but providers of it are now warning that things could be about to change dramatically. And where does heavy-handed political correctness fit into all this? It's a tough issue, particularly when workers can earn more stacking supermarket shelves than caring for kids. Here's 6:30's Maggie Palmer.
Chloe loves trucks and dolls and daycare. She's four and has been going to childcare since she was 11 months old.
One of the advantages in working with the staff at my daughter's service, we know how incredibly hard they work and what an amazing job they do.
A job they do for more than 800,000 children under 12. But the amount many junior carers are paid is of real concern.
And you can get more packing shelves in Coles than you can as working as a childcare professional.
The minimum hourly wage in Australia is $15. An entry-level childcare worker earns just 34 cents more than that an hour.
With qualifications, the pay goes up slightly. Still though, it's not a lot.
The staff are simply not paid according to the responsibilities that they have.
So it's no wonder keeping staff is tough.
Recruiting and maintaining our current staff is our primary concern at the moment.
The turnover is around 30%, which is alarming, and that equates to around 15,000 workers leaving the industry each year. And the reason they're doing that is because the wages are too low. They can't afford, passion doesn't pay the rent.
From next year, the government is introducing new rules, among them improved child to carer ratios and minimum training levels for staff.
The new reforms will put an emphasis on education and care for the first time ever. And so we will see that all workers working in childcare will have a qualification.
A great idea, according to parents and industry, but finding the staff to fill the roles will be tough and it won't be cheap. The Australian Childcare Alliance predicts when the changes kick in next year, the cost will rise significantly.
From $13 to $22 a day per child, which is a huge impost on families.
Many not-for-profit centres already meet the new child-to-staff ratio requirements. They argue the cost pressures will fall predominantly on privately run childcare centres who stand to lose money from their bottom dollar.
Yeah, they need to make sure they're providing the best quality, and if that means increased costs for them and or lower profits, so be it.
The regulation also cracks down on discipline techniques and encourages consultation with families before celebrating events like Easter and Christmas. Breaking those rules could mean individual staff and the centre themselves face fines up to $50,000. Chloe's mum believes the changes are an investment in her daughter and the nation's future.
So for every dollar that's spent in early childhood education, research has shown that society saves $17 down the track in terms of health, welfare initiatives, etc. as well. So we should be investing, and the government should be investing in high quality early childhood education, because we know it makes a difference.
Maggie Palmer there.